you're in the business of car repair and service, you're no doubt aware of the latest mega trend, electrification. And while vehicle manufacturers are stepping up production of electrically powered vehicles, Tesla has been producing them for over 15 years. Even though Tesla only manufactures fully electric or BEVs, otherwise known as battery electric vehicles, they still require all sorts of technical fluids to help them function to the best of their ability. For example, they still require brake fluid as with conventional powered vehicles. The coolants they use are needed to keep the battery and the power management components from overheating or undercooling in order to achieve maximum output and efficiency. Then there's the technical fluids needed for the gears connected to the e-machines. And today we're going to talk in more detail about our recently added EDF-2 fluid and ATF-64 profile, both applicated to Tesla vehicles and are part of our recently launched Pentosin EV Ready fluid range. Tesla models S, X, and the Roadster were the first of their range brought out onto the market. And these vehicles require the Pentosin ATF-64 fluid that is used in the dry e-axles. More on that in just a moment. The latest models from Tesla, their Model 3 and Model Y, require our Pentosin EDF-2 product as these are used in their wet e-axles. So, the subject of the e-axles being wet or dry is very important not to get them mixed up, as there's a big difference in the design of the two electric axles, namely the interaction of the technical fluid with the e-gearbox. What dry means when referring to the e-axles used in the Tesla models S, X, and the Roadster is that the technical fluid is only in contact with the gears and is kept separate from the e-gearbox. The wet e-axles in the more modern Teslas are not only working in the gear mechanism to cool, clean, reduce friction, and optimize efficiency, but the fluid circuit of the wet e-axles is also interconnected with the e-motor. In other words, the EDF-2 fluid is in contact with the e-gearbox and interconnected with the e-motor at the same time. This means that the EDF-2 technical fluid needs additional characteristics to be supported, such as fluid conductivity, for example, which is not necessary for the dry e-axle. As you can see, the Pentosin technical fluids are moving in step with the mega trend of electrification and the technology developments of OEMs to help even the most modern vehicles of today keep running at their absolute best. If you have a question regarding our EV Ready fluid range or any Pentosin technical fluid, feel free to post it below or on the CRP Automotive Facebook page. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and be among the first to learn about new videos like this one. Thanks for watching.